What is going on, everybody? It's your boy Nathan Muskills, and in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to complete Razorback, the easy guide to beating Razorback, the final boss in the raid. This is probably where everybody gets stuck, right? Because there's a lot of things you can do wrong, and a lot of it has to do with your build. So we'll talk about that all in this video, and I'll be trying to give you guys the easy way to do it, so that way you take your time. It might take you 35 minutes, 45 minutes just to beat this boss, but you guys will get through it, and as you guys perfect that, you guys can cut down the time and beat it within like 5, 6, 7, 8, 10 minutes. But we'll start off with the easy way for you guys to do it, and then I'll let you guys just watch my speed runs to see how you guys can speed that up. So when you first drop in, the boss, the big boss, is right in the middle, and you can just divide this map into a big square, and you should have two players teamed up. So you have one where you see where I'm at right now. This is one generator. There's four generators in a small square. So where Freddy is across from me, that is four. North of me, where Angel at, that's gonna be two. And then across from him, where Thick is at, that is going to be three. So that is one, two, three, and four. And my battle buddy is gonna be the Great Archon. So he's behind me. So what you wanna do is have four guys on the inside, four guys on the outside. The job of the four guys on the outside is pretty simple. If you guys are gonna take this nice and slow, all they have to do is clear all the adds. So since the inside is where a lot of the work gets done, we'll talk about this first. So we're gonna rewind it a little bit and show what I was doing. So we know there's four generators, right? So you guys have to communicate when you guys get on these. You guys have to count down, say, hey, 3, 2, 1, we're getting on. Because if you look, there's a percentage going up. I'm at 30%. You need those all to hit 100% around the same time. If one gets at 100% too fast, you'll get these rockets that shoot at the person who gets there too fast. But once this hits 100, on both sides, exactly where you're seeing right now, there's going to be these little red grates that open. You have to either shoot it with a crossbow or shoot it with your guns. When you destroy it, then you have to throw a frag grenade in. Once you throw a grenade on both sides, it will open up the weak points and you have to focus. So what we focus on, what I recommend you guys doing, is having everybody come to the south side first, focus on the weak point that we're shooting right now. So you're gonna do these same steps for every weak point. But focus this one, and you guys should have enough DPS to destroy the weak point each time. Now we're gonna have to do this on both sides, and I'll show you that in a second. Now after you destroy the weak point, you guys gonna roll off, because the big boss is going to shoot out two missiles. You roll. Everybody should head back to the area because a boomer is going to come out. And that is where either the guy up top has to call the boomer or the guy at bottom. So they'll call it out by boomers at one, boomers at two, three, four. When boomer comes out, what he's going to try to do is he's going to try to set off the missile. And the missile, if he gets that off before the guys on the outside can destroy it, that's the end. That's a wipe. Then you have to start the whole thing all over again. And once you guys do kill Boomer, you guys are going to call for the guys to get on the inside. And everybody's going to say, okay, 3, 2, 1. Everybody's going to go on the inside. And that way you can start it over. Now you're going to do the same thing on the other side. Remember, when this gets to 100, you guys are either going to use a crossbow or you guys are going to shoot this with your guns. So like, you can destroy it with your LMGs. Like, some people just like shooting it with their LMGs. Some people like having survivalists on the four guys on the inside so they could just go switch off. So one guy uses the crossbow, one guy throws a nade. Like, this guy's using his crossbow first, then I'm throwing my nade. Once it's open, we shoot the drones. So I recommend shooting these drones while they're just sitting here, finish them off, and then you're gonna go to the other side. Now when you get to this side, to play it safe, I call this the safe way to complete Razorback, you're just gonna want to leave this at 10%. Now once you get this to 10%, have everybody go back to their areas, kill Boomer, and then the next time you guys do this, you guys will be on damage phase. And I'm gonna skip forward to that part, right? So we all go back to our own sections, and then I'm gonna skip forward to us going into damage phase. Now we're already got everything set up, we're at 100%, we throw the nades in, everybody's shooting the drones real quick to knock out some of the drones. Now we're gonna go into damage phase. So what that means is, as soon as we finish off the little bit of 10% we have for the weak point, that means at the very top, the health bar is gonna pop up, and we can drop that at least to half health. Once you drop it to half health, it closes. So we're just waiting for them to get their side open. They just got their side open. So we're gonna destroy this weak point right here. Once we destroy this weak point, we only have a little bit left. Look at the top. Okay, there we go. We have half health. So now we can put out enough DPS to drop this to half health. Once we get this to half health, it's automatically going to close. So there's four phases right here. You have to do this 25%, 25%, 25%, 25%. So now we have to be on the lookout for Boomer. So look, Boomer came out again. Usually after you finish each phase, you'll have a Boomer. So I'm already over here ready to help my teammate out. We're going to finish off Boomer. Now that we finished off Boomer, we can get back on there. Everybody should either grab ammo if they need ammo because they're back at their section. And then we're going to say, hey, everybody, let's get back on. And then we're going to do the same thing until we can get this half done. So we're going to work on the south half first because I always feel like that's the harder half. And then you want to work on the north half. Now, a little secret I did and I tell a lot of my teams to do is leave the top half health, leave like 10% left of health. So look, we're going to destroy it. We already destroyed one weak point. We're finishing off this weak point and we're going to go into damage phase. Damage phase is when you can hit the health. Now, what I always tell my teammates is leave like 10%. The reason why is because once you go under 50%, you get two boomers. And for newer teams, that gets kind of tough. So I always say leave like 10%. You see how we just left 10%, so we're still above the shield. Once you go below that, you're going to have two boomers. So we're pretty much done on this side, right? We're going to go to the north side, and we are going to wipe that side out. And then when we come back to this side, it's just one less thing we have to do. Now, you don't have to do it like this, but this was just a tip that we did when I was helping out a couple teams do it that were struggling having two boomers. Because the great thing about it is you can take off another 25% of health without getting two boomers. So you'll be at about 35% health before you end up getting two boomers. And that's what's really cool about this method and why it's for, I call it the safe way to do it. Like, this isn't what we do on our speedruns, but this is a safe method for you guys to try. And once you guys get back on, you guys are going to do the same method. It's going to go to 100, but this time we are shifting to the north. So the two guys at the bottom will shift to the north. The great thing about over here is because a lot of times you can have the top two guys help a lot more because the weak points are out in the open versus the ones here, they're a little bit more covered, so it's harder for people to help out. But this side, look, when I get to the top, the guys up top can actually help if they, like where Hassoun is at, he can help shoot the weak point and we can actually drop this. So you can have your top teammate shooting drones. Once he's done with the drones, he can start firing here and you could probably hit one and a half. But if you want to play it safe, just worry about knocking out one. Everybody goes back. Remember the missile shoot. They're going to shoot always two missiles. You roll and then you roll again and you will always miss those missiles, right? You'll never get hit by the missiles. And then you go back and you wait for them to call out Boomer. Once they call out Boomer, you clear Boomer. Then you tell everybody to get back on. Now on this one, just like we did on this side, you leave it at 10%. And then you go for damage phase. So you have to do technically three phases to get to damage phase. So we're just shooting the drones here. Now you're going to see everybody pushes back up. We're going to hit the right side now. And we're going to get it almost to complete. We're just going to keep firing all the way until we can. And I end up shooting the heal up there, but ignore that. But yeah, so you keep shooting, you keep shooting, you keep destroying it. And then once we get this down, you're going to see we're almost complete with it and it closes on us. So the next phase will be damage phase. You have everybody roll back. Just make sure everybody's rolling. You see my unbreakable save me. So if you haven't seen my builds that I'm using, I actually have both these builds on my channel, except I don't use the AK anymore when I'm running the I run double LMGs or I run an LMG in the Nemesis, but I have both my builds that I use for the speed runs that we set world records with on my channel. So if you want to check out those builds, those are on my channel. And that's what I would recommend for you guys either running outside or inside. So now we are in damage phase for the other side. Now remember, once we do damage phase on this side, we get two boomers. So everybody has to be on the lookout, has to be calling it. The outside guys, this is where they have to be on point. They're going to say boomer one, boomer two. So look, we're already at damage phase. As soon as we get 25% here, which is the max you can get each time these health bars open up, we're now going to have two boomers. So this is where everybody will call it out. We'll head back to our section. As soon as you guys kill the boomers, that's when the guys on the inside should be pushing back to get back on. If the boomer's not on your side, when you have two boomers, help out your teammates. If you can shoot from 1 to 4, do that. If you can shoot across, do that. Once you kill the boomers, you communicate and everybody gets back on and you just do the same thing over and over. Now, once you get to the final damage phase on this side, you got to do the same thing, right? Like you shoot the crossbow inside, you throw a nade, and then everybody comes to this side you hit it. But then we're still going to have 10% on the opposite side. So we're still going to have to do this one more time, right? Now, if you didn't leave that 10% and you guys just went for it, well, that's one less rotation you have to do. But since we were doing it safe, this is what we're doing. This is what I say. If you guys are struggling too bad to kind of deal with those boomers, well, then do it like this. But if you guys all have really good builds, you don't have to leave that 10% like we did. This is just an easier guide for you guys to do that. You guys can cut that out. So right now when we do that, we would head back to the computers. But since we left 10%, we still have to do the other side. So now we are finally on our last damage phase. We went back to the other side. We hit the weak points just like you were doing. Because remember, you still have to shoot the weak points on the other side. But we finished all the weak points. And now we're going to go into damage phase. So if you do leave 10%, you still have to do weak points on the left and right. So we're going to finish off this weak point right here. Once we finish off this weak point, we have the final 10%. And there we go. Now, once you do this, everybody at 1 needs to go to 1. Everybody at 2 needs to go to 2. Everybody at 3 should go to 3. Everybody at 4 goes to 4. Now, once the monitor lights up red, that's when you can shoot it. So you shoot your side, and when you finish with yours, I would recommend going to have one guy go to the one on the left and one guy go to the right. So we're at 2 right here. I would send 4C to 1, and then I could go to 3, and you can help out. And when you finish, that's it. That is how you beat it. And when you guys beat it for the first time, you'll be screaming like we were screaming too. This is my actual first run, and I decided to do the video off that one just because we were so happy about doing it. And I think it's just really something special that a lot of you guys, once you guys learn to do it, you guys will enjoy it. I can remember when I first started doing the raid, it was a pain. Like, I was frustrated. I didn't know what we were doing wrong. I didn't know what was wrong in our game plan, but it was a lot of communication. And once you get that communication, you kind of know the tactics, it becomes really easy. Now let's get into the outside guys, because the outside guys are crucial. They keep the ads off of the guys on the inside. They help with the drones. They make sure that those dogs aren't sniping them, because dogs come in. When these drones are coming, if there's ads on the guys on the inside, you got to be in there. You got to be covering your side. Right now I'm on 2, but I came over here to help out, because if you don't get rid of those drones, they can end up dropping the guys on the inside. So helping them out with drones, and make sure you're taking out as many ads as possible, because you don't want these ads adding up. And last but not least, make sure you're paying attention to Boomer, because when Boomer comes down, you should be able to drop him by yourself. Like, I'm able to take out Boomer with my DPS, with the amount of damage to elites, with one of the builds I put on there for you solo. I can drop him by myself without my teammate helping me. Now, if you do need your teammate helping you, that's fine. Just make sure he knows that he has to back you up, right? Because if you need backup, just call out. That's what communication is there. Your battle buddy is on the inside, and he should always have your back. You should always have his back. And as long as you guys are working as a team, you guys should complete this perfectly fine. But yeah, the outside guys have it pretty easy. Their job is really to clear all the ads, ask for help with boomers when needed, and the inside guys do a lot of the work. Make sure once you guys complete it, you guys are paying attention to these monitors. Don't mess up at the very end. Everybody head back. Once you finish the monitors, split off to go help out somebody else. So we finish off 2. We are going to push to 3. So once 3 comes up, we can shoot it a little bit and help them with the DPS, because the faster you can shoot it, the more DPS you can have on it, the faster you guys can complete this, and that way you guys don't mess up. And once you guys destroy all the monitors, that's GG. I hope this tutorial helps you guys out. I hope this gets more of you guys more confident in finding teams. If you guys still haven't found a team, check out my Discord. There's been a lot of people in there saying, hey, looking for group for 1, 2, we're missing somebody, do you have a build? Make sure you guys go in there with builds. Don't join a group, say, hey, I want to do the raid, and then you go in there with a horrible build, and then they get mad at you because you didn't have a really good build. Like, focus on your build, guys. Like, grind a little bit. Work on those builds first, and then go after the raid, because you're going to have a lot easier time completing the raid with a good build. Remember, I have 2 builds that you guys can use for the inside and outside. 2 different ways to mod those builds. They both work good. You can run it with a Nemesis, you can run it with double LMG, you can run it with the Demolitionist class or the Sharpshooter class. Really doesn't matter, but you can run it different ways. And that's what I recommend for you guys to complete this raid. If you still have any questions on this raid, let me know in the comment section. I just want to say thank you guys again for all the support. Leave a thumbs up if you found this video useful. If you guys are still struggling with this boss, just ask me, guys. I'll try to help you as much as I can. I'm a little busy this week. I am flying out in the next couple of days out to E3 and then on my way back. So I'll try to answer the questions as best as my ability. Remember, if you're new to my channel, first time watching a video, hit the subscribe button, turn the notification bell on. So when I release a video, you guys get notified. And until the next video, nothing but skills is out.